Hello everyone, welcome to ETHIO Blend. This is Solomon. In today's tutorial, I'll show you how to set up lighting for glass cleaner product in Blender. Welcome to Part-2 of our lighting tutorial. Please support us by liking this video, subscribing to the channel, and turning on the notification bell for updates. Stay tuned until the end. Let's get started. First, split the viewport window. Press Shift A to add a camera. Reset the camera by pressing Alt R. Switch to top view using the number 7 key. Move the camera forward along the Y axis. Rotate it by pressing R and the X axis 90 degrees. Press 0 to switch to camera view. Go to the Scene tab and set the resolution to 1080 by 1080. In the camera properties, adjust the focal length to between 90 and 110 as desired. Position the camera by moving it along the Y and Z axis. Now press Shift A to add a plane. The glass cleaner object already appears above the plane. Switch to edit mode and scale it using the S key. Next, scale along the X axis. Select the edge and press E to extrude along the Z axis. Select the middle edge, press Ctrl-B to bevel, and add loops as needed by scrolling. Then hit Smooth Shade. Go to World tab. Before making that change, switch from Blender Render to Cycle Render. The environment light strength is set to 1, so switch to Render View. The environment will appear gray. Set the strength value to 0. To incorporate lights that better align with our product preferences, switch to the front view by pressing 1. Press Shift S to select cursor to center. Then press Shift A to add an area light. Move the light along the Z axis to create a top light. In lamp property, set the size to 2. We want the top light to be the primary source, so increase its strength to 300. The current intensity creates harsh shadows. To remedy this, we should scale the light until it covers the entire area. Now the shadows are soft and the light is diffused, resulting in a calm and cool ambience. One top light provides a nice atmosphere, but we need more for better lighting. Position it higher, neither too far nor too close. And rename it to top light for easier identification. Hide this light to see the effects of others on the objects individually. Add another area light by pressing Shift A. Rotate it by pressing R in the Y axis 90 degrees. Then move it to the right side. Since the object has tall height but small width, change the light shape from square to rectangle. Set the X size to 2 and the Y size to 4 for the rectangular light. Optionally, scale it along the Z axis for size adjustment. Keep the light's strength 100. One thing I will tell you is that when you use a lamp, you will not get what you want immediately. You can try to change the size and strength of the lamp repeatedly until you get what you want. The number of lamps varies depending on the product we make. Press Shift D to duplicate the light. Then move it left along the X axis. And rotate it 180 degrees on the Z axis. Adjust the light strength between 150 and 200 to soften the shadow created by the right light. Unhide the top light to see the lights together. So far, we have nice lighting. Crucially, these three lights give us a good idea of what the full shape of the object looks like. Center the cursor by pressing Shift S, and by pressing Shift D, duplicate the lights again. Then press Shift S to move the selection to the cursor. Switch to top view by pressing 7. Move to the front along the Y axis. And rotate it minus 90 degrees on the Z axis. It's very intense light. The main purpose of this front light is to illuminate only the level. For this, press Shift S to center the cursor on the selected light. Then add an area light with Shift A. Delete the large light by pressing X and set its size to 1 to focus on illuminating the label area. Hide the other lights to see this front light more clearly and reduce its strength to 50, as we need a softer light to brighten the label. The plastic material of the bottle can create unwanted light stripes if the front light is too strong. Next, add the final area light from the back. Duplicate the front light by pressing Shift D. Move it back along the y-axis and scale it slightly along the x-axis. Flip the light in the opposite direction by rotating it 180 degrees on the z-axis and scale it a bit more in the x-axis. This backlight is useful since the bottle and the liquid are transparent. It makes the liquid glow rather than a solid color. I will demonstrate the light's effect on the liquid during texture. Decrease the strength to about 50 is enough. Now unhide all the lights. We have around 5 lights. Don't hesitate to add as many lights as you wish, depending on the object's material. Return to the render view and hide the ground plane for a better view of the product's interaction with the lights. Finally, unhide the ground plane. The reason you change the size of the light is that every time the size of the light is increased, the light will be scattered or diffused. When it comes to product rendering, sharp shadows should be avoided or minimized as much as possible. I am not saying that sharp shadows are not necessary. It depends on the type of the product you are working on. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and join our community. Until next time, goodbye.